The amazing journey started in March at the Players Tour Championship, where he staged a remarkable comeback from 0-3 down in the final against Neil Robertson to take his sixth ranking title with a 4-3 win. In September, he succeeded in his homeland, capturing his seventh ranking title at the Shanghai Masters. The final against Xiao Huodong was the first all-Chinese ranking event final in snooker history, with Ding winning 10-6. Following that, he swept away Adita Mehta 5-0 in the final in his first Indian Open. He became the first player to win back-to-back major ranking event titles in the same season since Ronnie O'Sullivan in 2003. He continued his impressive run at the Chengdu International Championship. Ding defeated Marco Fu and became the first player to win three consecutive major ranking events since Stephen Hendry in 1990. After the hat trick, Ding reached top three in the world for the first time in his career.
The year of 2013 really has been tremendous, winning four titles and also finishing as a career high, world number three. How do you describe this past year?
I think it's a great year for me, and win three tournaments in a row. That's impossible for now snookers in they're all playing good.
And in total, of course, you won four titles in that year.
Yeah, it's happiness. It's the most happiness this year. So I've never done this before. And it's a good experience to win it. More confidence, I feel, how to make it right in the tournament.
But at the beginning of 2013, did you expect yourself to perform so brilliantly? What has made a difference for you to become another level of Ding Junhui?
Yeah, it's a big, big difference to myself. I feel it when playing. I push myself very hard, you know, when sometimes playing bad frames, I miss bad shots. A bit give up like before. It doesn't happen anymore. That will help me to build my confidence and stronger in the games, more concentration.
Does that really mean that you are more mature than ever?
Yes, yeah, that means right. I'm doing the right things and choose. I try different things. I always try to be stronger myself. And you know, all the top players like Ronnie O'Sullivan, you can't miss any balls when you play him. I just always improve then to keep the high level to play the top player in the world. So that's why my dreams when I was kids.
If I have to ask you to pick one most memorable game in your career so far, which one would that be?
It's quite hard to pick. And this year, in the earlier time, I played Neil Robertson in the PTC final. Really hard game, a really good game to win it. World number one. 3-0 down and come back 4-3. It's give me a lot of chance, build my confidence.
Neil Robertson, evident primo. Oh, bravo.
In that tournament before, I never think I can win any tournaments. That's the different. It's like the time is changing all the things in that time. So that's what happening in a few weeks ago, win three tournaments in a row. Maybe it just starting that time.
Now you're currently ranked number three in the world. How far are you from world number one?
It's not far. It's very close, but it's close. It's very hard. It's most hardest things when close to the top. Last step is always the hardest. So I have chance to go number one, and it's only half a season happening. Another half season next year. Mm-hmm. So yeah, I'll do my best.
Is getting world number one spot more important than hitting more 147?
I think it's going to world number one is most difficult. It's 147. Everybody can they can make it, and also the 147 sometimes you need a little bit luck. So anyway, some players like Ronnie, if they want to make, they make.
Do you have any role model? Or you mentioned Ronnie a couple of times already. Is he your role model?
I don't want to be like that. You know, it's, people have a bit different styles. Just do yourself. It's like me now, just do myself. I never learn somebody's styles to keep like that.
In your growing process, Is there any player who actually influenced you a lot?
Neil Robertson, Selby, or Ronnie, they all have one or two things that, like, influenced me. But I have something to influence to them. So I just, you know, snooker is a difficult sport. So you have to improve everything, not just one thing. It's like Judd, he's only attacking. It's nobody says he's good safeties. Mm-hmm. So that's only attacking. It's nothing to say about anything else. So like Ronnie, good safety, and good attacking, good ball buildings. Everything's good. He can't find any weakness for him. That's the most difficult to play than players. I wish I can do that. So I practice everything, like safety, rest, attacking, long balls. Everything's to. Yeah, I have some weakness, but it doesn't show a lot like that.
Do you think the fact that the ability of your speaking English well helps you because you understand the game now very well and you can even communicate with them?
Yes, a lot helps. You know, when I can speak English, I can talk to other players. That's the last thing to do that. You know, the English people is more different. They think different. One shot, and maybe they have many different thinking. They think different choice. For Chinese player, I think they always have one answer, but in English they have many different answers.
You know, Xiao Ding, you always give people this impression of being a very calm person. Calmness is really like part of you. I just wonder if this kind of calmness is something you were born with or something you trained later on in your career.
I'm nervous.
Do you get nervous at all?
Of course.
You don't show that, do you?
Never show that. It's nobody show that. Mm. I think it's nobody want to show that in the matches. You just keep like poker face.
That's exactly what I was about to say. A poker face is very difficult to read, and this is where you purposely do?
Yeah. Sometimes, you know, some people doesn't like me because they say it's never smile.
You do, but you do now.
Yeah, it's quite hard when you won't keep smiling and talk too much and losing concentration. Maybe some players, they're doing well, they have experience to do that, but I don't think I can do that as well. So I just keep my face in the same still, so my opponent never read me and never know what I'm thinking about. Missing balls or playing well, they doesn't know anything about me. That's the most dangerous in the matches.
And that's part of your strategy?
Yeah.
Now we know your trick. I do feel that, you know, throughout all the years we've been interviewing you, you have changed quite a bit. You've become, to me, more outspoken, outgoing, and you like to smile, and you like to actually make fun, and so forth. What has made a change?
I like to talk to people. Before, I doesn't like to talk a lot. That makes many bad things. Playing not well, but not talking. Somebody just guessing and doing bad words or bad things.
So you decided to change?
Yeah, I like to change myself. I like to talk to them what's happening at the moment in the matches between both of us and playing, let people more understand.
Do you feel lonely in the Chinese crowd, meaning the Chinese snookers are catching up? However, you're sort of like on a one-man band. You are the one single-handedly leading this crowd.
I feel the big pressures, like a few years ago, not many Chinese players are doing well. Mm-hmm. So everything's precious on me. That time is quite hard, and now it's less precious. Mm-hmm. It doesn't feel lonely any time because I know Chinese players are going to improve quickly because I have a lot of tournaments, I have more chance to play them, the top players in the world. And also now they have plus me and Marco, like 11 or 12 players from China. They are in England playing the tournament. I'm happy to see that someone can share this.
Many are predicting that down the line the sport of snooker is going to be like golf. Say the Chinese side will really dominate the world. Do you think this is going to happen very soon?
It's looking like getting well, and they have a snooker academy in China, in Beijing. And also a lot of parents like to let their kids to learning snookers and training. It's just a start. It's not yet. Just look at good start for now.
But it's happening.
It's happening, and maybe 5-10 years you can see that what's happening in that time, but not now. I think now just it's like the players. Last year they say Li Hao Tian is a very, very good player. Mm-hmm. It's gonna be like who? He's only 16. He can't say anything about this in the future. So it's, when it's a good start, just keep the start good and keep doing well the job. That's the importance.